Hello chess friends and welcome to the channel. Today I start a new series about modern chess prodigies. We will start with Ramesh Babu Pragnananda, who is an Indian chess prodigy. He was born in Chennai on August the 10th, 2005. His FIDE rating now, that is less than 13 years old, is 2529. I'm going to show you one of his game that was played in the Under 20 World Championship in 2014 when he was only 11 years old. And this game shows his attacking skills and his precise calculation. That's why the title is Acceleration Toward the Enemy King. Let's start with the game. E4 for Pragnananda, C5 for his opponent, that is Slaven Pastor. So we have the Sicilian defense. Knight in f3, e6. Black wants to go into the Khan or Taimanov of Sicilian. Knight in c3, so not an open Sicilian for white. A6, a4, knight in c6, bishop in e2. And you see that white has already developed three pieces and can castle at the next move. D5 for black, e capture d5, e capture d5, d4 now, c4, and castles for white. Bishop in f5 for black. And here it's better to develop the kingside bishop because with white that already castled and the black king still in the middle, it's better to speed up the operations on the kingside. Rook in e1, indirectly attacking Black's king. Bishop in e7, good move that develops the piece and shield the king. Now, bishop in f4, a natural developing move. And knight in f6. So, this natural move has two drawbacks. At first, the knight in g8 was protecting the bishop in e7, and now this protection is gone. The second and more important factor in this position is that this knight in c6 will be attacked by the d-pawn that gains a tempo and accelerate toward the bishop and toward the enemy king if white can play a bishop sacrifice now. In fact, Pragnananda plays this strong bishop sacrifice with bishop capture in c4. D capture in c4, d5, the pawn advance and attacks the knight with tempo. This knight must move, so another protection of the bishop in e7 is gone. So knight in b4. And this is the real mistake of the game, because it was better here for black to give back the piece and save his king castling. If black castles now, this will leave white with a little advantage but nothing decisive. But after knight in b4, we have d6, the pawn keeps advancing and threatens the bishop, of course, that is pinned on the king. Now bishop capture in c2, attacking the queen. Queen in d2, knight in g8, protecting the bishop, knight in d5, another piece advance and is another attack on the pinned bishop, and also this knight is threatening to jump in c7 with check. Black plays knight in d3, attacking the rook. And if we come back one move, we see that also knight capture in d5 is still losing because queen can capture in d5. Now the problem is always the same, that the bishop is pinned. Queen in d7, knight in e5, attacking the queen and also giving the possibility to white queen to capture with check in f7. Queen capture in d6 seems the strongest move for black now. Queen capture in f7 with check. King king moves in d8, and queen capture in g7 is enough because it will win the rook if black doesn't do nothing. Queen in f6, attacking white queen, but knight in f7 we check. King must move, and rook capture in e7 is enough, because of course the knight can't capture the rook because black would lose the queen, and the queen can't capture the rook because knight in d6 we check wins the queen. Same thing if black queen would have captured white queen, because here the rook would win the would win back the queen. So also this line starting with knight capture in d5 is losing. That's why black tried knight in d3, attacking the rook. But now knight jump in c7 we check. King's moves in f8. Now d capture e7 we check. And this capture regains the piece that was sacrificed, also attacking the queen. Knight capture in e7. Knight capture in a8 wins the rook. Now, of course, this knight can't capture here the rook in e1 because he's pinned on the queen, and it would be checkmate in one for white. So knight goes in d5, and now the knight in d3 could really capture the rook in e1, but it will be a rook against two minor pieces. So black tries to complicate things after queen capture in c2, knight capture in f4, queen capture in c4, attacking both knights. That now they are protecting each other, but also controlling f7 square in front of black king. Now queen capture in a8, rook moves in d1, attacking one knight. Knight in e2 we check. King in f1, attacking also the other knight. One of the knight retreat in f4, so the two knights are protecting each other again. But now, after knight in e5, with that threatens mate in one, black resigns, because it would be forced to interpose this knight on the queen's line and to lose the other knight. In this position, we see that also queen in e8 protecting a7 doesn't work, because rook in d8, this simple deflection wins at least the queen, because the queen of course can't capture. If not, queen capture in f7 is mate, is checkmate. So a nice game by Pragnananda that teaches us the principle of acceleration and how to calculate precisely. So today's game is over. I hope that you enjoyed it, and if you did, please like the video and subscribe to the channel. See you soon. Thanks for watching, and goodbye.